Isaac Muhanguzi's day starts early at 5 a.m. He feeds the cows as he prepares them for milking. Muhanguzi owns 100 cattle that he looks after at his Kabaihura farm in Bushenyi district. Every day he milks 30 of the cows. He employs 10 people on the farm, and these help him in the daily chores on the farm, like milking and grazing them. He milks the cows twice a day, morning and evening, and takes about 400 liters of milk daily. Muhanguzi, who has been in this business for more than 15 years, says he realized that selling raw milk was giving him a raw deal, so he decided to add value to the milk so as to get better returns. So of the 400 liters he milks daily, Muhanguzi reserves half, 200 liters, for value addition, specifically making yogurt.
The advantage is it's another way of marketing. So it helps you sell the same milk, but in a different context, in a different picture.
He advises that the farmer needs to have enough milk to make the yogurt that is popular with many consumers.
You must have good milk, good fresh milk. Because we occasionally test our milk for any other bacterial contamination.
He makes the yogurt from this building that is separated from the milking place, but still within the farm. He invested quite a bit of money in the yogurt making machines, like these ones used in boiling and mixing.
We bring our milk from the milking shed, and fresh as it is, we put it in our stabilizer. Sorry, our pasteurizer. The pasteurizer's job is to heat it or to boil it to 90 degrees.
He explains that other than milk, the yogurt maker needs a number of other items to make the product.
We also add a stabilizer to make it thick, to make the yogurt thick. And that is, we put sugar at 60 degrees. We put the stabilizer at 45 degrees. Then we heat up to 90 degrees. Then we cool it again to 45 degrees, where we put culture. Culture is a bacteria, but a good bacteria, good for the body.
He emphasizes that a weighing machine is critical to help the farmer have the exact quantities for making yogurt. Muhanguzi makes sugary and non-sugary yogurt to cater for the different tastes of consumers.
One, we add sugar for those who want sweetened stuff. Then we keep some, well, we call it plain yogurt, for those who want unsweetened things.
For a farmer who can't afford this mechanized process, Muhanguzi has another option, which is simpler. One needs a saucepan to boil the mixture, and then following similar steps in the mechanized process.
The saucepan will do the boiling, but then you may need a thermometer, basically that.
He packs the yogurt in the professional manner, not only to preserve it, but also attract customers.
You must have the passion for what you are doing.
But mechanization comes with a number of challenges, and Muhanguzi advises that anyone planning to go into yogurt making must appreciate these and prepare adequately.
Our biggest challenge is on high power costs. These machines use three-phase power, yet we have single-phase. So that's our biggest challenge.
Despite the challenges, Isaac Muhanguzi urges farmers to do value addition because it's the only way they will get better returns from their produce. Ivan Chimurichikozi, NTV.